Get ready to match the stars. Bill Daly, Brett Summers, Jack Carter, Danny Flagg, Richard Dawson, and Judy Carr as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And now here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rayburn.
Thought you'd never get here. Hello there, ladies. I mean, thank you very much for the enthusiasm of your welcome here, and I welcome you wherever you are, and I welcome you too.
Hello, Jim.
Listen, there's one thing I forgot to tell Bill Daly.
What's that?
You may not know this, but Richard Dawson no longer wishes to be called Dickie Dawson. You can't call him Dickie Dawson. You can no longer say that. Will you remember that?
Be known as no. Ramona.
Can you call him Dickie?
No.
Dickie. So Richard Nixon.
Dickie? No, I never will call you Dickie again.
Okay. By the way, I enjoyed our dancing last night.
Thank you, Dickie. Oh, I'm sorry.
And he won't call you Bill Bailey.
Listen, let's say hello to our two players here, Polly Kislick and Shirley Klein. Hello there, players. When time expired last time, Polly had just finished her end of the round and scored one match, and we had a question. We have a question. Yes, we have a question for you, Shirley, and we'll get to that right after we get to this message for you. All right, let's finish a game we started yesterday. Here's the completion of round one. Shirley, we've got this for you. It's 1-0 in favor of Polly at this moment. Folks, here it is. The real reason the big bad wolf didn't eat the three little pigs was because he was blank. The real reason the big bad wolf did not eat the three little pigs was because he was blank.
I've been burned.
You're the best.
Thank you.
Okay,
no,
the lower tier is
ready. Fastest.
Come on, Brett.
I'm ready.
There's a question, Brett. Read it yourself.
Moving right. You are canceled. Go to your home.
Okay, they're all ready, Shirley, so we'll get your response. The real reason the big bad wolf didn't eat the three little pigs was because he was...
full.
Full. He was full. He just came from a restaurant, Bill.
Listen, we work very well together, right? We should get an act. How about that?
Close.
Stuffed.
Stuffed and full is a match. Okay. 1-1 the score at this moment. Brett.
Don't tell me this isn't a match, because it is. Not hungry.
Not hungry. That is
not hungry.
Okay. Very good, Jack.
What a delicate group we have today.
Yes.
A wolf is a wolf. And if you're a wolf, you don't eat a pig because you're Jewish and kosher.
That's that.
Sweet. Klein didn't know that, but I did.
Okay. Fanny, what do you say?
I agree with Jack. Jewish.
He was Jewish.
Good girl.
Richard, that is not necessarily the case.
What is the case?
You could be a vegetarian.
It could be a vegetarian. God, you couldn't tell. Would it help? What do you say?
Mine was a bigot.
He was a bigot?
Yes.
Okay. All right, so it's 2-1 in favor of the champ. We go to round two and ask Polly to make a selection.
I'll take A.
A. You must score once, of course, to stay in the running here. All right, here it is. The marriage counselor said to his secretary, "Hold all my calls. I'm having blank with my wife." The marriage counselor said to his secretary, "Hold all my calls. I'm having blank with my wife." Richard is the only one, I guess, who is not participating in this, and I'll bet you're sorry that you were so good last time.
Why happy?
Why aren't you playing?
Pardon?
Because he matched with Polly last time.
Because I was superior the last time.
Yes.
Yes, very.
All right, everybody's ready. So, Polly, we'll get your response. The marriage counselor said to his secretary, "Hold all my calls. I'm having blank with my wife."
I'm having a conference.
A conference with my wife. Are you married, Polly?
Yes, I am.
Oh, you frequently have conferences with your husband?
Yes, it's my husband.
I see. Okay. A conference is her answer.
I
what's
down,
yours?
I was having a blank with my wife. No. Oh. Having a fight with my wife.
A That's fight with my wife. Hold all the calls. Okay, no match there. Brett?
You're not married to Jack Klugman, are you? Fight!
Fight, ah. Yeah, all right. So the two of you match, Jack.
Well, we sound like a lot of losers up here, don't we?
Why?
I've been married so many times, I now live 9 blocks from my house. If the marriage counsel I know, I was having a fight with
fight.
My wife.
Three fights so far, Polly. What do you have, Fanny?
A fight.
A fight. Four. Now, you must match Judy or the game is over. Judy.
Well, mine's like a fight. It's a row.
A row is a fight. It's not a match. So Shirley wins another game. Congratulations. Will you come down, please? Okay, Shirley, we congratulate you. And for Polly, we have thanks for being with us on Match Game 73. A gift for you backstage. Many thanks. Goodbye, Polly. Now, Shirley, we'll get right to it because you know how it goes here. We polled a recent studio audience and we got their best response to this. Blank pan. The answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. Second most frequent response, $250. And the third, 100. Now, which three celebrities would you like to get a little assist from here?
I'll take Dick.
Dick, what do you say? Richard.
Peter Pan.
Said Dick. Peter Pan. Very good. Okay, there's one.
Bill.
Deadpan.
Deadpan. Okay, so you got Peter Pan and Deadpan. And one more.
I'll take Brett.
Frying Pan.
Frying Pan. Okay, you've got Peter Pan, Deadpan, and Frying Pan. You may choose one of those or give us another one that's in your head right now. What would you like to do?
Peter Deadpan. I'll say Peter Pan.
You'll say Peter Pan. Okay, say Peter Pan.
Peter Pan.
You said it. There. This is a new microphone. Isn't it terrific? Delicate? Okay, you say Peter Pan. That's what you said. You said Peter Pan. I heard you say that. Okay, let's see if it's under the $100 response. Deadpan is the one that Bill gave it. Okay, it's there. Still looking for Peter Pan. Are you under the $250 response? No, you are not. Frying Pan, that's the one that...
It's got to be.
It's got to be.
Do you believe?
Yes, Wendy, fly.
Do you believe?
Fly, Gene, you can do it.
Well, if you believe, then under that $500 response will be Peter Pan.
Yeah!
See, you had a bunch of believers here with you, Shirley. So you've got the $500. That means you now play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. You know you have to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. Has to be an exact match. Which one will it be? Want to look him over?
I'll try Bill.
Sure.
You'll try Bill.
She hasn't seen me on a show yet. Missed me 8 times.
All right. Oh, Bill, you get ready to write. Here is the $5,000 question.
Oh, boy.
Inch blank. I-N-C-H. Inch blank. Okay, he's finished. Shirley, we need your response now. How do you fill in that blank? Inch?
I'd say inchworm.
You'd say inchworm? Well, you know, if I were playing, I think I'd say inchworm, too. Let's see what, for $5,000, what Bill Daly says. What do you say, Bill?
What are you doing for dinner tonight?
Inchworm! Everybody had inchworm.
I had it too.
You had it too, yeah.
Well, a lot of worms here.
It's an exciting moment for you, I know, Shirley. Have you got plans for the money?
I sure do.
Okay. I guess that's as far as we ought to inquire. The money is $6,200, and we'll get back for her to play another game right after this message. Okay, we're ready to start another game, and to do that, we've got to meet a new player. So let's welcome Mr. Brian Bradford. Hi, Brian.
Hi.
Where are you from, Brian?
I'm from Los Angeles.
What do you do?
Well, I'm a senior at California State University at Los Angeles. I'm majoring in television production, and I also am a page at another network.
Really?
Keep it a secret.
Yeah, all right. I started out as a page, and look at me, nothing ever happened to me.
Impressive, James.
All right, Brian, you're the challenger. We ask you to make a selection.
Okay, well, I'll pick A.
A is what he wants. We've got a brand new game here, and everybody plays. Janet said, that nearsighted dentist tried to fill my blank. That nearsighted dentist tried to fill my blank. All right, the lower tier is ready, upper tier.
I'll wear my glasses for that.
Okay, thank you. Here we go. Brian, that nearsighted dentist tried to fill my...
nose.
Nose. The audience agrees with you. They say the nose is the answer. What do you say, Bill Daly?
Look at that nose. Just look at it. Look at that fabulous
nose. There's
one. I had nose before. I was going to stay with it until I got it right.
All right, Brett.
I love your singing, Bill. You have a swell voice. Ear, and I got so nervous that I ate a piece
Bill
of my
ear. Okay,
well,
Jack.
We've got a lot of cavities going, don't we?
Yes, we do.
I got in on Brian's wavelength, because he's... Is that pollution in school you're studying? Well, anybody from a swamp needs a nose.
Nose. So that's two for you, Brian. Let's see what Fanny Flagg has.
Yes, I'm very nearsighted, and I said nose.
Nearsighted dentist tried to fill my nose. There's another match. Mr.
Now,
Dawson.
The A's have nothing, and the no's, I believe, are four.
Right. Okay, Judy.
Ooh, your lucky day, no's.
No's. Wow, that's five. Shirley, you got to go some to stay in this game now. Here we go. Listen carefully. Alexander Graham Bell picked up the telephone he had just invented, and a voice at the other end said, blank. Alexander Graham Bell picked up the telephone he had just invented, and a voice at the other end said... All right, Shirley, are you thinking about this?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Have you already formulated your answer?
Awesome.
All right, in a second I'll ask you for it. Just as soon as Fanny is writing the great American
novel. Not Fanny's, not a career.
Well, I haven't written my mother in months.
Now she's ready, and now, Shirley, I call on you. Alexander Graham Bell picked up the telephone he had just invented, and a voice at the other end said...
Are you there?
Really?
Like
okay. All right, she says, are you there?
I was going to say, don't call me, I'll call you, but I'll go with the wrong number. Okay?
Wrong number. You just invented the phone, and right away,
right
see,
away,
it's been ever thus, hasn't it? Yes. Brett?
Get off the line.
Get off the line. That must have startled him.
The yes. Worst thing was he thought he was inventing the light bulb. He picked it up and tried to get light out of it. But the other voice said, your 3 minutes are up.
Yes. Are you there is her answer, Fanny. What's yours?
I said, the number you have called is not a working number.
That's a good one. What do you say, Richard?
It was a very tiny voice, and the voice said, hello?
Hello?
There's a little midget.
That's right. One more chance here.
I don't know why, I just said thanks a lot. I don't know.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah.
Okay. So at the end of round one, the score is 5-0 in favor of Brian, the challenger, and we'll go to round two right after this. We've finished Brian's half of round one and Shirley's. And at this moment, the score is 5-0 in favor of the challenger. We'll go to round two, and Brian asks you to make a selection.
Well, I don't know any better, so I'll stick with A.
A. Now, you matched everyone but Brett last time, so Brett, this is only for you.
How do you think I feel?
It's only you.
Golly.
Listen carefully now, Brett. Hopalong Cassidy said, the reason they call me Hopalong is that before I got my horse, I used to ride a blank.
You ever felt like a loser?
Brian?
Pogo stick.
A what?
Pogo stick.
Says pogo stick. Pogo stick.
That was what I was trying to think of. Pogo stick.
What did you think of?
All I could think of was kangaroo.
Kangaroo. Okay.
Kangaroo. over your tie.
Now, Shirley, you've got to match five celebrities to score a tie. However, you could win it if you match everybody up there. Here we go. Everybody plays. One hippie.
I'm trying to get sympathy from the audience.
One hippie said to another, "If your ears get any dirtier, we'll be able to grow blank in them." One hippie said to another, "If your ears get any dirtier, we'll be able to grow blank in them." That's a rotten question. Oh.
I love it.
You like it?
I like it. I think I got a winner this time.
Fanny's writing another novel.
Well, no, she's writing the second page to her mother.
Oh, she don't spell too well, but she means well.
Let's see how Shirley handles this. One hippie said to another, "If your ears get any dirtier, we'll be able to grow blank in them."
I'd say peanuts.
Peanuts?
Peanuts.
Peanuts?
That's your answer, Shirley. Peanuts is what she said. Five to tie, six to win. Bill.
I was going to say peanuts, but I didn't, unfortunately. I said, made a lot of money together. Grass.
Grass. All right.
That's a hippie, right?
Yeah. Got to match Brett and all the others.
Brett. I was going to say potatoes because I have young children and I always say that to them, but I said grass.
Grass it is. So the winner is Brian Bradford. Congratulations, Brian. You come on down here. Okay. So, Brian, that's $100 for you. If you'll stand by for a moment, we'll say goodbye to Shirley Klein. You know, you'll be leaving here with $6,200, and that puts a smile on your face. Shirley Klein. Thank you, Shirley. Bye. Okay, here we go. You know how you've seen this, haven't you?
Right.
You know that we polled a recent studio audience, Brian. We got their best response to this. Blank lady. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you can match it. Second most frequent response, $250, and the third, $100. Now, which three celebrities would you like to get a little help from?
Okay, I'm going to try Brett.
Brett, how about first lady? Say?
First lady is her answer, okay?
Fanny.
Fanny, what do you say?
Oh, my, that's a hard one.
Blank lady.
Fat lady?
Fat lady. That's a circus term.
What about Richard?
What about Richard?
Shady lady.
Shady lady.
Okay,
so
to go.
Fat lady, first lady, and shady lady. You can choose one of those, Brian, or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Well, I'm going to take Brett's, and I'll say first lady.
First lady.
So far, I've been batting zero, Brian. I don't know.
That's the answer we're looking for. First lady. Let's see if it's under the $100 response. First lady, it is. Right off the bat. Okay. Now, just for curiosity's sake, what do you think is under the $250? My fair lady?
Fair.
All right, let's see the $250 response. Pink lady.
Oh,
yeah, that's...
Right.
All right, landlady. Landlady, all right, here's a $500 response. My fair lady, you were right. The audience had that. Okay. Now, Brian, you've won $100. That means you'll play for 10 times that amount or $1,000. To collect the $1,000, you've got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. It must be exact, and it's time to choose one now.
Boy, I tell you, I don't know. Okay, I'll choose Brett.
Okay, Brett.
It's your day in the barrel.
Brian, you face me if you would, please. And here is the $1,000 question. Brett, are you ready? Blank glass. G-L-A-S-S. Blank glass. Brett is ready. So, Brian, we ask you for your response now. How do you fill in that blank? Blank glass.
Broken glass.
Broken glass. All right, Brett, for $1,000, may we see your answer, please?
I'm a leper. I'm a leper. Stay away from me.
Hourglass. No, that's not a bad answer, Brett. Don't cry. Don't cry, Brett. Now, Brian, you're up to $200, and you're still a champ. You're going to meet another player and play another game, and you may be back here again. Here is Sandy Dickinson. Hello, Sandy. All right, you want to get aboard the carousel. You know Sandy Dickinson? How'd you enjoy the ride out here, Sandy?
Oh, it was fine.
Good. You didn't get dizzy or anything like that, did you?
No.
Good. You want to tell us a little bit about yourself?
Oh, I'm a housewife, and I'm from Riverside, and I have two children.
Okay. How old are your kids?
3 and 1.5 years.
Okay, all right. Now, you know how this goes, and we wish you the best of luck, as we do to Brian. We ask the... we're going to hold it here for a second. Just for a second or two, or three or four, while you receive these messages. I'm sorry to say we've run out of time.
Oh, no.
We found out who Sandy Dickinson was, and will you come back next time, Sandy?
Sure will.
All right, I guess you'll be back.
Sure.
You got a taste of the money, and you may get more. All right, good luck to both of you next time around here. And is there anything... Listen, we must all remember to watch Bill Daly on the Bob Newhart Show, right?
Yeah,
don't
right.
Would you watch me, please?
Yeah.
Please. The present?
Oh, the present, yeah. What was the present that Fannie Flagg gave you?
That's my present from Fannie... The shirt!
A T-shirt.
What's under it?
Oh, I see. Yes. What is the significance of that shirt? What is it?
You were probably very glad to get rid of that, were you?
Sing the music for them, Fanny.
What does the music sing?
How dry I am. No, I drew her name in the Christmas raffle. She drew mine and I got a paperclip.
You did. warms the cockles of your heart, doesn't it?
I beg your pardon.
Listen, you will all come back next time, won't you, folks?
Yes.
Good. We'll look forward to seeing all of you. Gene Rayburn here for Match Game 73. Please join us next time. Bye.
Today's consolation prizes are a Texas Instruments calculator. Add, subtracts, multiplies, divides in the palm of your hand. Advanced electronic technology at your fingertips from Texas Instruments. And from the Chapstick people, Chapman's Lotion, the rich, non-greasy lotion for problem skin, Chapman's Cream for rough, dry hands. And Rice-A-Roni, the big flavor side dishes, so quick, so easy, saute and simmer to flavor perfection. Rice-A-Roni, the San Francisco treat. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production.